kinds of intervention program Philippines. The first is the primary intervention, includes general measures to promote social justice and equal opportunity which tackle perceived root causes of the offending. The second is the secondary intervention, includes measures to assess what children as risk. Third is the tertiary intervention, includes measures to avoid unnecessary contact with the formal justice system and the other measures to prevent the offending.
So, good day, everyone. So, right now, I'm going to discuss what is restorative justice all about. So, we learn more about that as we go through our lesson, which is restorative justice. So, what is restorative justice? So, restorative justice is a theory of justice that emphasize repairing the harm caused or revealed by criminal behavior. It is the best accomplished through cooperation processes that include all stakeholders. So when we say restorative justice, we are pertaining to what will be the reintegration or repair that we could provide to the injured party. So restorative justice is not a new concept. It represent a traditional view of crimes by recognizing that crimes hurt everyday people. So today, when a crime is committed, the government views that crime as a breach of the state's law. However, restorative justice focuses on the injured victim as well as the broken law. So, and seeks to heal those injuries and restore the right order for the community rather than solely offering retribution. Okay, so buot pa sa buot, when we say restorative justice, wala siya nag-focus sa punishment nga ihatag sa offender to have justice, but rather than we are focused on the injured victim as well as the broken law. So, and those injuries and restore or ibalik the right order for the community rather than solely of offering retribution or punishment. Okay, so like that paragraph said, that restorative justice is not a new concept. Okay, so it is representing the traditional view of crime, that a crime could hurt people, because when crime committed, it means we violate the law. So, but then, in restorative justice, we are more focused on victim or the injured victim rather than giving punishment to the offender. So, restorative justice, as what I've said, it more focused sa kanang injured victim rather than to punish the offender. So, ang mas gituunan niyag pansin ani is to restore or i-restore ang na-injury nga biktima rather than to punish the offender. Okay, let's proceed. So, victim are involved and given a voice in every stage of restorative justice processes. Offenders are held accountable to make things right with their victims through restitution and victim-offender mediation. So restorative justice recognizes that communities are also hurt by crime. Okay, so when someone hurt with regards to commission of crime, dili lang katunga tao mo nasakitan or naapektuhan, but rather they entire community, because ang law man nato ang na violate. Okay, let's proceed. So, and involves members of the community determining the appropriate sanctions to be imposed and in restoring of offenders back into the community when they have paid the price for their crime by working to repair the damage they have caused to their victims, families, and communities. Offenders develop the sense of responsibility that is essential to leading a productive life upon their eventual return to society. Through these processes, restorative justice seeks the reintegration both victim and offender, productive member of a safe community. Okay, that's the most important and essential in living a productive life. Okay, so dapat daw ma-realize ni offender ang sense of responsibility when they committed a crime. Okay, so like sa atong gibasa, so through this process, restorative justice seeks to reintegrate both victim and also the offender to become a productive member of a safe society. So it means dili lang pabor na ang restorative justice ni victim, but ni offender also. So di ba we all know naman nga in this last 2 decades ang mga tao kay na frustrated nga sa dili maayo nga pamaagi sa paghatag og justice sa victim, di ba? Because they only focus sa kanang for giving punishment, no? They focus on giving punishment. So that's why wala kaayo nahatagan og kanang sakto nga justice ang mga victim, because they focus more on giving punishment to the offender. So, kay di ba kabantay mo nga kanang ang isa ka offender or nasentensyahan na siya, na preso siya and di nakagawa siya. And then mag-commit gihapon siya og balik og crime, di ba? So it means wala na hatagan og sakto nga essence or the true essence sa pagbag-o sa sulod sa presuhan, because they are just focused on punishment-oriented approaches rather than restoring the behavior of the offender as a law-abiding citizen. Okay, so that it may carry different names such as healing justice, biblical justice, transformative justice, and relational justice. So dugay na ni siya nga idea nga ang restorative justice, na lang try ka ng mga new names or new terms. Okay. How is this biblically based? What about an eye for an eye? So when we say an eye for an eye, no, it's so familiar sa Code of Hammurabi, I think. And then, ni Lex Talionis, yeah. And then, the God of the Bible is a God of Shalom. So, when we say Shalom, is peace or right relationship. So, when we say an eye for an eye, kanang, kung unsa ang imong, unsa gibuhat sa imuha, maupoy buhaton atong offend, maupoy buhaton nimo sa offender. Panalitan, si offender, gipatay niya ang usa sa imong family member, so mupatay pug kag family member nila. Kung ba kung unsay gibuhat nimo say maupoy ibalos nimo. So kani diri nga slides, ako lang na siyang ikuan i-summarize. Nagtalk siya about sa vengeance. So when we say vengeance is kanang pagpanimalos, yeah. So naay kanang mga text sa Bible nga ingon si God nga, "You shall not take vengeance, so let me be the one take the vengeance." So kanang gilimitan lang daw ang kanang paghatag og kanang pag-revenge ani diri nga kwan. So 3 principles form the foundation for restorative justice. So there are 3 principles form the foundation for restorative justice. 1, justice requires that we work to restore those who are being injured. 2, those most directly involved and affected by crimes should have the opportunity to participate fully the response if they wish. And 3, government's rule is to preserve a just public order, and the communities is to build the maintain a just peace. Okay, let's proceed.
Let's proceed on conventional justice system, sometimes referred to as retributive justice. Ask 3 basic questions. So, maodo ni kanang 3 basic questions. So, what laws have been broken? So unsa daw ang kanang batas or unsa daw nga balaod ang gi alabag. And then the second one is who broke the laws. So kinsa ang kanang nakasala or naka-commit to crime. And then the third one is how shall the lawbreaker be punished. So sa unsa daw nga paagi nga gi-punishan, unsa daw nga punishment ang gihatag sa ka-lawbreaker or sa wrongdoer. So those are the three basic questions on attributive justice. So the fundamental questions of restorative justice on the other hand are who are has been harmed. So kanang sino daw ang kanang kinsa ang nabiktima or kinsa ang na-injured. Yes. Then the second one is how can this harm be addressed or repaired. So unsaon daw siya paghatag og healing or pag-restore sa harm nga na kuha sa ato ang victim. So the last one is who should address or repair the harm. Kinsa daw ang naka-address or kinsa daw ang what we call that one. Kinsa ang mag-ayo sa harm nga na-experience sa ato ang people learn right from wrong if we don't focus on punishment. Don't we have to be consequences for harmful action. So which is na po din point no nga unsaon daw pagkabalo sa usa ka tawo nga mali to ang yang gibuhat kung wala tay ihatag nga punishment. But restorative justice is committed to direct accountable and healing what has been broken. So dili mo sa restorative justice kay dili daw kailangan ang punishment or dili daw kailangan i-punish ang isa ka tawo para ma-correct or makanang makamatngon bitaw, but rather helping the wrongdoer or the offender to gain greater understanding on the impact of his or her action. So kanang di daw punishment ang ihatag nato sa mga wrongdoer ani sa dili sa kanang restorative justice o dili daw punishment ang ihatag nato sa wrongdoer or sa offender or law violator o unsa pa nang mga tawag nila. Dapat daw mapa-release nimo ang sa ilaha, mapa-realize nimo sa ilaha nga kanang unsa ang impact sa ilahang gibuhat nga certain ilahang action. No, dapat daw kanang diri sa kanang restorative justice murag iparealize nimo sa usa ka offender ba, iparealize nimo sa wrongdoer nga kanang unsa di ay ang impact ani nga kuan nga iyang gibuhat nga action. So it said no, dapat nato iparealize ilaha nga ang ilang gibuhat nga ang impact ilang gibuhat nga action aron mahimo silang more responsible sa ilahang mga action, sa ilang mga lihok. So og para na lang pod to prevent further harmful actions nga ihatag sa ilang mabuhat.